In this video, I'll be discussing about battens. See, when these battens are also the plates, extra plates, which are used to connect two adjacent columns for the stability purpose. If these plates are provided in an inclined fashion, they are called as lacings. And if the same plates are provided in a horizontal manner, then it is called as battens. So here you can see two I sections are connected by using the extra plates, which are placed in the horizontal manner, and these plates are connecting the two flanges. As they are placed in the horizontal manner, they are called as battens. If the same plates are kept in the inclined fashion, it becomes lacings. Starting with the problem here. So before starting the problem, I would like to tell you that in the code book of IS 800-2007, the clause 7.7 is entirely dedicated for battened columns. See, all the formulas, all the checks which I am going to use in this video over here will all be present in this. The C is nothing but the center to center of battens. I need to tell you two things here. If you look at this figure, these two battens are called as end battens, and this is called as the intermediate battens. You have to remember this thing. And the center to center distance between the adjacent battens is taken as C, as you can see in the code over here. The center to center distance between the adjacent battens is called as C. So all the formulas which I'll be using are extracted from this clause 7.7.1 in page 50 as well as page 51. All the spacing of the battens, everything will be taken from here. So we're starting with the problem now. So design a compression member along with batten connection using two channel section facing back to back, which carries a factored load of 1600 kN using M20 bolts of grade 4.6 for connections. And the end condition is one end is fixed and the other end is hinged. Here, the design procedure is same entirely. The only difference once again here when compared to lacing system is when you get the value of slenderness ratio, there in lacing system you used to multiply the obtained value by 1.05 and you used to proceed further. Whereas here in battens, the whatever value we get, the slenderness ratio, you have to multiply by 1.1 according to the code. If it is a lacing system, the obtained slenderness measure should be multiplied by 1.05. If it is a batten system, it will multiply the obtained value of slenderness ratio by 1.1. So the lambda will be 32.2. So now starting with the design of battens now, the spacing you are having a condition here. It should be less than 50 into R minimum, or it should be less than 0.7 times of lambda into R minimum. The C is nothing but, I told you just now, it's a distance between center to center of adjacent battens. So having two conditions for that, one is 50 into R minimum. So R minimum you will be calculating in the design step, the same value you can use here. So it will be 50 into 28, so we are getting 1400. And for this condition, 0.7 times of lambda is 32.2 we are getting, that you have to use here, into R minimum is 28, once again you are getting 631, so you can go with 600 mm. You have to choose least among these two. He is saying that it should be less than these two values, so it should be, you can choose any value which is less than 631.1, so I will be going with 600 mm. Once again, he is calculating the distance between CG to CG of adjacent channel sections. It is nothing but a D plus width of flange minus C by Y on both the sides. So this distance from center to center of CG of adjacent channel section is 162.8 mm. So next, moving on to the depth or depth of the battens. I told you that they are having two types of battens. One is end batten, which are at the extreme ends, top and bottom. And the other battens which comes in between these end battens are intermediate battens. So while calculating the depth, say for end batten, you're having two conditions. It should not be less than S. I told you what is S here. It is the distance between CG to CG of the two adjacent channel section which has designed as a column. And the other condition, it should not be less than 2 times of width of flange of the channel section. So the S you obtained as 162.8 mm. And 2 times of width of flange is 200, so I will be going with 200. He's saying that it should not be less than these two values. Okay, so I'm going with 200 mm. So for intermediate Manhattan, you're having two conditions. It is should not be less than 3/4 of S and should not be less than 2 times of V. You're getting these two values. So once again, he's saying that it should not be less than. So I'm going with this value, that is 200 mm. So all these conditions which I'm using here are provided in the code book, as I mentioned earlier. You can refer for that. Next, going on to the thickness of batten, it should not be less than 1/50th of S. So S is we have calculated, so it should not be less than 3.25. So you can choose any value which is more than 3.25 value. So I'll be going with 4 mm. So I've obtained the dimensions now. Spacing I calculated as 600 mm. The spacing between center to center of adjacent battens. The depth of end batten is 200. And the depth of intermediate batten is also 200. And the thickness we have calculated 4 mm. So this depth is 200, both end and intermediate. Thickness we calculated 4 mm. And center to center distance between them is also calculated is 600. So one thing you can observe here, we are not calculating the length. The length will be equal to the distance between this particular point till here. So we are calculating only depth and thickness. So moving on with the check. First you have to calculate shear stress, bending stress, shear force. So shear stress should be less than Fy by root 3 into gamma m naught, that is the condition. And then the bending stress, it should be less than Fy by gamma m naught, that is the condition. So here first you have to calculate shear force, which is given by Vt into C divided by N into S, which is given in the code book. Vt, we are aware the transverse shear is 2.5% of the column load into C is the intermediate distance we calculated in this previous steps, that is 600. N is the number of faces where you are going to plot the batten. So we will be plotting batten on both the faces of the column. So N will be 2 and S we have calculated 162.8. So shear force is 73.71. So next we will be calculating moment, which is given by Vt into C divided by 2N from the code book. So once again Vt is 40, which I calculated 2.5% of column load, C is 600, 2 into number of faces where you are providing battens is 2, we are getting this value here. So now you can compare with this formula over here for shear stress as well as bending stress. So shear stress is given by shear load by area, shear load you have calculated here 73.71 divided by area is depth into thickness, the depth is 200 and thickness is 4. So getting 92.14, the condition is it should be less than Fy by root 3 into gamma m naught. So Fy is 250, root 3 to gamma m naught is 1.1, so we are getting 131.21. obviously it is less than this value, so it is safe with respect to shear stress. Similarly bending stress, it should be less than Fy by gamma m naught, so it is given by 6m by td square. 6 into m is the moment we calculated here, moment is 6 in 10 raised to 6 divided by thickness is 4 and depth is 200. So we are getting 225 and it should be less than Fy by gamma m naught. Once again Fy by gamma m naught are getting 227. So it is marginally less than the condition here. So it is safe under bending stress also. So going on with the connection. So this will be the connection here. If you see from the top, this is where the bolts will be provided. So we are dealing with two thicknesses here. So lap joint, so NN1, NS0, and thickness will be least of these two thicknesses. That means I have to compare the thickness with battened plate and thickness of flange of channel section. So comparing those two, you have to calculate the value of T. So NN1, NS0, so bolt value are getting 32.8. So number of bolts is given by load by bolt value. So load, you have to substitute this particular value over here, shear force as load. So 73.71 divided by bolt value, that is 32.8, you are getting 2.2 volts. So we will be providing 3 volts for shear and 1 volt for moment. So totally 4 volts for each connection. So pitch and edge you can find out by assuming the dia of the bolt. So this is regarding batten connection. Thank you.